illallah.
Mr. Chairman, and my dear brothers and sisters, the subject about Muhammad in the Bible. A few decades back, when I started prying into this field of biblical prophecies, I started discussing with learned men of Christianity, asking them the question whether the Bible had anything to say about Muhammad. And invariably, every learned man of Christianity says, no, there's nothing in the Bible about Muhammad. And if there was such a thing, he said, we would have known it. One gentleman, a 70-year-old man, he said, my son, at that time I was quite young, he said, my son, I've been reading the Bible for the past 50 years. And if Muhammad was mentioned anywhere, naturally I would have known it. So I asked him, are there not hundreds of prophecies in the Old Testament regarding the coming of Jesus Christ? So a Dumini, a priest who happened to be there at the time, he said, not hundreds but thousands. That there are thousands of prophecies in the Old Testament regarding the coming of Jesus Christ. So I asked him, out of these thousand prophecies that you are talking about, is there a single prophecy where Jesus is mentioned by name? That the name of the Messiah is not a name. It is a title. Like the mayor of the town, like the king of the country, or the president, or the headmaster, the chairman, these are titles. These are not names. Christ is not a name. Prophet, the word prophet is not a name. These are status, the status. So Christ is not a name. The name is Jesus. When the child was born, the Bible says, he was named Jesus by the angel before he was in his mother's womb. What was he named? Jesus, not Christ. Christ is the title. So I said, is there a single place in the Old Testament where Jesus is mentioned by name? That the name of the Messiah will be Jesus. His mother's name will be Mary. His supposed father will be Joseph the carpenter. And he'll be born in Bethlehem in the reign of Herod the king. Is there any such thing? He says, no. Then I said, how do you know that there are thousands of prophecies? He said, no. Prophecies are word pictures of something that is going to happen in the future. Word pictures. And when those things actually happen, come to pass, you conclude, you deduce that this is the fulfillment of that. So I said, you reason, you deduce to discover Christ in the Old Testament. He said, yes. So I said, why should you not do the same about Muhammad? Out of 1,000, you can't find a single one with a name. Why are you demanding that I should show you Muhammad spelled out? M-U-H-U-M-M-E-D. Or any variation of spellings. Why? But later on, as I gained experience, I discovered that Muhammad is mentioned by name in the Bible. It is in the original language, in Hebrew. It is in the Song of Solomon, chapter 5, verse 6, where it says, Hikko mamittakim vi kullo Muhammadim zahdudi vi zahri bainat Jerusalem. In the Hebrew, original manuscripts, it is still there today. Every Hebrew Bible has it. Chapter 5, verse 6 of the Song of Solomon. The word there is Muhammadim. They have translated that word Muhammadim as altogether lovely. Now when you say that my beloved is altogether lovely, you don't know he's talking about Muhammad. See, altogether lovely. Like instead it was written, my beloved is the praised one. He said, anyone could be praised one. He says, no, the Muhammad translated means the praised one. But you can't see Muhammad there. It's praised one, praised one, praised one. Similarly, altogether lovely, altogether lovely. You're reading altogether lovely. But what's the original? It's Muhammadim. Muhammad, in is a plural of respect in Hebrew. And people seem to have misunderstood that. The Western nations, they see plurality of numbers where plurality of respect is intended. Like in the first verse of the Christian Bible, in the Jewish Bible, the book of Genesis, the first book, chapter 1, verse 1, it says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The word God in Hebrew is Elohim. El in Hebrew means God. Elah in Hebrew means God. Elohim is a plural of respect. Where the Christians read Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In the mind, when they say Elohim, they say his Father, Son, and Holy Ghost is intended. When it says God said, let us create man, they think that as is Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. But ask the Jew, any Jew, who is this as? He says, no, it's a plural of respect. Who is im? He says, it's a plural of respect. In every Eastern language, we have two types of plurals. Plural of numbers and plural of respect. Arabic, Hebrew, Urdu, Gujarati, every Eastern language has it. If you haven't got it in your language, you are just unfortunate. See, like the royal we. When the Queen of England, she declares that we have decreed such and such. Who is this we? Ask her. She, her husband, and her son? No. Or the Prime Minister? No. We is a plural of respect. They call it the royal we. In religion, like Hebrew and Arabic, in these languages, we read in the Quran, same type of plural for God. I quote, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafizun. Inna, most certainly we. Nahnu nazzalna dhikra. It is we who send down the message, the revelation, and it is for us to protect it. Who is this us? Allah, Muhammad and Jibreel? No. No Arab Christian ever points a finger at the Arab Muslim to say, who is this us and who is this we? He'll be a fool to do such a thing because he knows that this in his language is a plural of respect. Im in Hebrew is a plural of respect. Elohim or Muhammadim, plural of respect. The word Muhammad is there. With the translated, I said this is the game that they play. They translate when it suits them. They translate names of people, which you have no right to do. And once you do that, you miss the mark, the whole thing is lost. Fortunately, some of these translations with the originals are still retained, like the word Messiah. In the Bible, you'll find the word Messiah as well as Christ. Christ is the translation, so we know this is Christ is the translation of the word Messiah. Peter. You see, one of the disciples of Jesus, the foremost, who was given that duty of feeding, Jesus says, feed my sheep, means my followers. Feed my lambs, meaning my followers. Feed them means look after them, guard them, cherish them. So, you say, Peter says, Jesus said, you read in some translations, thou art Peter, and on this rock I'll build my church. Thou art Peter. Jesus never heard the word Peter in his life. As the word Christ, he never heard in his life. He never heard the word Jesus in his life. Believe me, this word Jesus was unknown to him. When he was born, his mother didn't call him Jesus. She called him Yeshua. Common name, Esau. E-S-A-U, Esau. We say Eesa. In Afrikaans, they say Jesus. I say that because there's some couple of South Africans here, so they know what I'm talking about. Jesus, Isa in Arabic, Esau in Hebrew, classical Yeshua. That's what she called him. She named him Yeshua, a form of Joshua. Joshua translated, they translated